everybody. I recently saw a program that had to do with minorities speaking about, oh, you know, my parents raised me a fighter. I knew I would have to fight in this world. I felt really strongly about that because coming from a certain group of people myself, we've been prosecuted in the past and things like that. I think it's so important to teach your kids history and what their ancestors have gone through. But it made me think, do I want to raise my child to be a fighter? Do I want to raise my kid to constantly think that somebody's out to get them? Or do I want to raise them to feel confident because of who they are, not because of the color of their skin or their sexual preference or their religion? And not to say that I don't want to make my kids aware of things that are happening in the world. That's fine. But why would they walk around the world thinking that when somebody does something to them, it's because of where they're from, it's because of their skin color, it's because of their preference? To me, I prefer them seeing that as just a behavior towards them as a person, and if they're confident enough, they'll shrug it off. I don't want them to see that as a specific behavior that they would anticipate because of how they are, because I feel like that puts you in a victim mentality. If you think about it, you don't need to defend yourself unless you're victimized. It's like coming into the world constantly expecting something bad to happen to you or people wanting bad things for you. And while that might be true, you're kind of eliminating that nothing bad will happen and that people will accept you and love you the way you are, and these things do happen. And if you think about it, even if they're not from a minority, even if there's nothing specifically unique about them, people will still experience different types of adversity. That's just something that happens in life. But we don't necessarily need to attach it to something specific. If you're being taught that somebody will come at you, then as soon as somebody does something small, which might not be personal at all, you will be right on the defense. It's a survival, fight or flight mode, trying to protect yourself, when a lot of times that's not even necessary. If you wouldn't expect somebody to mistreat you, you wouldn't even see it. It wouldn't even be there. Did he just dogged me and put me down? Like, what was he trying to do there? And it'd just be like, oh, who cares? If you're very confident with yourself, adversity won't touch you. You'll shrug it off. I know, because it happened to me, because I was very unpopular and very insecure when I was still dealing with my trauma and my childhood. But as soon as I changed as a person and I gained my self-confidence back, people were still saying the same things about me in the hallway, and they were still whispering the same things behind my back. But the thing is, it didn't even matter to me what they said or why they said it or how they said it. I just shrugged it off, and it didn't affect my life. So when we're constantly training our children to be warriors of this world and protect themselves at any price, we're kind of forgetting that we could just raise them to feel amazing about themselves. You can either teach them to go through life and constantly worry about adversity and then experience it, or you can teach them to go through life and not worry about anything and then experience the adversity. Because you can't control the world around you being anti-Semitic and homophobic and sexist and racist. The worrying about it and the worrying about it is not going to change whether we experience adversity. The only thing we have control over as parents raising our kids is to make them feel amazing the way they are. If you don't teach them that there's something negative about it, why would they ever feel negative about it? And when somebody else comes and tries to make them feel negative about it, they won't be expecting it. So they'll come home and say, oh, they said something about my this and that. Well, we still love you the way you are, and do you love yourself the way you are? Yeah, well, great, then that shouldn't matter. History has got full respect for me. Things that are currently happening in the world have full respect for me. Is it important to teach our children about what's happening around? Yes, it is important. But do I want to raise a warrior? Do I want to teach my child that they are ultimately a victim of the world? No, I probably won't, because I want to teach them to live life and not to survive through life. So again, this is just my point of view. These things can be very sensitive to certain people, so feel free to express how you feel about what I just said. And if you've got a different opinion, I will definitely read it and respect it, and I'm excited to hear your point of view on everything. And in the meantime, stay happy.